Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this webinar on 10 cyber safety tips every internet user must know. This webinar will be presented by Mr. Nikhil More. Nikhil is an online marketing expert at Quickheal Technologies Limited and has over 9 years of experience into digital marketing and a passion for technology, usability and photography. Nikhil is also a recognized expert in the internet marketing strategies for the antivirus industry. At Quickheal, Nikhil is associated with the cybersecurity program, which is the company's corporate social responsibility initiative. I will now hand over the proceedings of this webinar to Nikhil.
Good morning, everyone, and a warm welcome to today's webinar on 10 cyber safety tips every internet user must follow. Let's set up a few ground rules before we begin today's session. In case you have any questions about today's webinar, please make a note of the slide number and note of your question. At the end of today's session, we will try and answer all core questions possible. In case you come up with questions after the session gets over or after the Q&A session, you can write to us with your questions and we will be more than happy to help you answer your queries. You can write to us at corporatecommunications@quickheal.co.in. You can also watch the recording of today's webinar, which will be hosted on our YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/quickheal, and the presentation will be hosted on SlideShare. The URL will be mentioned at the end of today's presentation. Without any further ado, let's begin with today's presentation. So what are the topics that we would be discussing today? 10 most common types of threats that are present on the internet today, 10 internet security tips you must follow, and all the more important, how Quickheal helps you to be safe against all types of online dangers. Before we begin today's session, I would like to begin the session with an opinion poll. I would like to know your opinion about when you get an email from your bank which is asking you for your username or your password or for your ATM pin, what would you do? Would you provide the information that is asked to you in that email? Would you just reply back to the email with the given information? Would you ignore that email or would you report the email immediately to your bank? I would like to repeat the question for today's audience. If you get an email from your bank asking you for your username, password, and your ATM pin, what would you do? Would you provide the information by replying to that email with the details requested, or would you ignore the email, or would you report the email to your bank immediately? We have close to about 58% of today's audience casted their vote. I would give them another 10 seconds before I close this opinion poll and share the opinion results with the fine audience today. It's a very common practice that today, these days, we receive emails from banks where they ask information pertinent, not necessarily posing a threat, but sometimes they scare people by saying that we have seen malicious activity in your bank account and would like to verify the information by checking the information, and for checking the same we need your username and password. Most commonly these emails are sent to get this information. So in case you receive such information, what should you do is my question. I think we have almost everyone present today have casted their votes. I would now close the opinion poll and share the results with you. So 60% of today's audience feels that they should report the email immediately to the bank. 38% of today's audience feels that they should ignore the mail, and 2% audience feels that they should provide the information. Well, audience, you are correct. 60% people who have voted that they should report this email to the bank is the most ideal thing to do. Even if you don't report it, you can ignore the email, but please do not provide such information. These emails are sent by cyber criminals to fetch information from you. These are phishing attacks, which basically are meant to steal your financial information and cause a financial loss to you. So in case you receive such emails, you can just show them the way to the junk box, or you can just report to your bank, you know, walk into your bank, tell them that you've received such and such email from the bank. Is it true? Most likely, it's not true. So let's move ahead. So the most common types of threats on the internet today, what are they? The common types of online dangers most people feel fall are many, but we would like to discuss the most important of them, which includes phishing attacks. Now, phishing is a fraudulent act of acquiring private and sensitive information such as credit card number, debit card number, personal identification information, and it has user account names, passwords. Now, using a complex set of social engineering techniques, the computer programming expertise, which are basically cyber criminals, or phishing websites lure email recipients and web users in believing that such a spoofed website is legitimate and genuine. In actuality, the phishing victim later discovers that his personal identity and other vital information, such as his financial information, has been stolen and he's been exposed to such vulnerability. Moving ahead, spyware. Now, spyware is a class of malicious software that can track the work you do both on your computer and on the internet. And this information is about you is sent to someone who shouldn't have an access to such information. These programs can record the words you type on your keyboard, the movements of your mouse, the websites or the web pages that you visit, the programs or the softwares that you use, and these are the few things that they can track. Now, as a result of all this, they can undermine the security of your PC or your laptop and reveal confidential information about you, because with the every keystroke you do that has information probably about a username or a password that is being tracked by somebody. Now, computers become infected with spyware in much the same way they contract viruses. So because malicious web pages are a major source of spyware infection, you should pay extra attention to websites you visit and make sure that your browser settings are secure. Keyloggers. Keyloggers, as I mentioned again in the previous slide for spyware, keylogger is a technology that tracks, records consecutive keystrokes on a keyboard. Because sensitive information such as usernames and passwords are often entered on a keyboard, a keylogger can be a very dangerous technology. Keyloggers are often part of malware, spyware, or an external virus which are injected on your or implemented on your system to steal your information. With this, I would like to know your information about your opinion rather about softwares that you download on your PC. Now, please let me know your opinion about what would you do or what you should do before you download a free software on your PC. Should you check if the software has a verified publisher, has a good rating and reviews from other users, or should you simply download and install without any checks? I will repeat this question for you. Before downloading a free software on your PC, what should you do? Should you check if the software has a verified publisher and has good ratings and reviews from other users, or should you simply download the software and install it without any checks? I would like to know the opinion from today's audience about what would they like to do in case of, you know, they're downloading any free softwares available on the World Wide Web. Mind you, when I talk about verified publisher. Before you install any software, there is a pop-up window which tells you the information about the creator or the manufacturer of that particular software. Say for example, if you are installing a quick heal software, it will show you that the publisher of the software is quick heal technologies. So that way, I would like to know from you that do you check or should you check if the software or the publisher of the software is a verified publisher or not? Okay, I would now close the opinion poll and share the results with you. Well, 82% of today's audience feels that they should check the software has a verified publisher and has good ratings and reviews from other users. Well, as 36% of today's audience feel that they should simply download and install without any checks. Well, you can download a software, but it's always recommended to check the source of the software. As I said earlier, there could be softwares which would be designed to steal information from you. Now, not necessarily that, but there are softwares which are not required or not necessarily come from a genuine source. Now, whenever you use a software, there's a particular intent of using any software, and that intent is comes into picture only when the software does what it's meant to do. And a genuine software maker or a creator would create the software the same way it has to do things what it has to do. But a software which is not a genuine one will definitely create problems for you instead of helping you in any way. Let's proceed further with today's session. Trojan horse, another danger that comes your way a lot of times. So a Trojan horse, or often shortened as Trojan, is a type of malware designed to provide unauthorized or remote access to user's computer. Trojan horses do not have the ability to replicate themselves like viruses. However, they can lead to viruses being installed on a machine since they allow the computer to be controlled by a Trojan creator. The term gets its name from the Greek story of the Trojan War, when the Greeks offered Trojan a peace offering in the form of a large wooden horse. However, once the Trojan wheeled the horse behind the closed gates and the night fell, the soldiers inside the horse climbed out and opened the city gates, allowing the Greek army to infiltrate Troy and capture the city. Trojan horse software operates the same way, where the Troy is your computer and the horse is the seeming application. Trojan horse can assist an attacker into turning a user's computer into a zombie computer, stealing various data such as credit card information, installing more malware, keylogging softwares, and other various malicious activities. Also, it is possible for other crackers to control the compromised computer simply by searching for a computer on a network using a port scanner and finding ones that have already been infected with the Trojan horse. Trojan horse continues to increase in popularity and currently account for majority of malware found on the web. Moving ahead, drive by download. Drive by download attack is a malware delivery technique that is triggered simply because a user visited a website. Traditionally, malware was only activated as a result of the user proactively opening an infected file. For example, opening an email attachment or double-clicking an executable that had been downloaded from the internet. Unfortunately, hackers have become more sophisticated over recent years, and this level of interaction is no longer required. Malware may be served as hidden codes within the website content. Served content like banners, advertisements, and used as a vehicle of hacking and other cybercrime. A simple act of visiting a site is enough to get your computer infected or personal details stolen. Let's know about, since we have talked about so much about viruses and so much about vulnerabilities on the internet, let me ask you something about websites that you basically use. Do you think all these websites are genuine, or are these websites good and helpful? What is a general? This is a very generic question that I would like to ask you. When you talk about websites, do you think all genuine looking websites are safe to use? Is it true or is it false? Let's know for what the fine audience has to say about genuine looking websites. So the other day I was browsing the web and I came across a site which looked like a social networking site, and I was about to enter that site, and thank God I didn't, because there was something different that I noticed about that site. I'll let you know once I close this opinion poll and I share the results with you, but there was something very peculiar that I found out about that website, and I did not proceed and entered my login credentials. So like to just wait for another 5 seconds before I close this opinion poll and share the results with you. I think close to 80% of today's audience have casted their vote, so I can safely close this opinion poll and share the results. Okay, so 76% of today's audience feels that it's false. So they say that all genuine looking websites are not always safe to use. 24% say that it's true, all genuine websites are safe to use. So the answer is false. There are even legitimate websites that can be compromised by hackers and may infect your system. Very recently, we have had so many news about various websites being compromised, various websites being taken over by as a hostile by cyber criminals, and websites. When I say websites, I talk about genuine looking websites. The incidents that I mentioned to you was about a social networking site I usually use. When I went to that site, and through a link that I browsed on the internet, I found that the login page looks exactly like the Facebook page that I use, but I noticed that the URL of that page was something else. It was not facebook.com, and that set up an alarm in my mind, and that's where I was about to enter my username and password, but when I looked at the URL, I found the website was not genuine. And that saved me, because if I would have entered my username and password, I would never log into Facebook, but I would have lost my login credentials of Facebook to a cyber criminal who have done anything with my account. Let's move ahead. So 10 simple internet security tips that you must follow. The first step is be smart with your passwords. Now, when you create a password, I've been talking about creating passwords very frequently in all my webinars, because passwords are the gateways and they are the major security protocols that will allow an entrance to the entire universe of social media, of personalized information, of your personal identity over the World Wide Web. So passwords need to be strong. And by strong, I mean the password should be a combination of letters or characters in uppercase, lowercase, special characters, numbers, all together as a mix. Do not use weak passwords like a lot of people use passwords like 1111. Most commonly used passwords, you can even do a research on the internet about it. Those are very dangerous. You can use a strong password, and I would recommend it again. Although I know it is a difficult task, but if possible, create separate password for every account you have. Do not keep a same password for all your accounts. Let's move ahead. When you use your device, mobile phone today is replacing the computer, the laptop, as they say. So whenever you are using your mobile phone or your smartphone, always lock your device. You can use a PIN, password, pattern, or even a face lock to lock your device. Use patched and up-to-date browsers and software and operating system. Computer programs are often large and complex. It's inevitable that some of the software you use on a regular basis contains undiscovered errors, and it's likely that some of the errors could undermine your computer's security. Software developers continue to find these errors, however, they release updates to fix them. It's therefore essential that you frequently update all the software on your computer, including the operating system. If Windows is not, I'm talking about Windows operating system, if Windows is not updating itself, you can configure it to do so by clicking the Start menu, selecting all programs and clicking Windows Update. This will open Internet Explorer and take you to Microsoft Update page, where you can enable the automatic update feature. Similarly, it is important to make sure that all the other software installed on your computer is updated. In order to do it, you first need to know what programs you have on your computer and perhaps uninstall those that are not essential. You can go onto your Windows Control Panel, Programs, and Add and Remove Programs. Then you can review each program it's there, and you can also verify it is if it is in the latest version and how it can be updated automatically in the future. Now, an unpatched software and is basically vulnerable to most serious cybersecurity risks for the internet today. Lesser threats include operating system holes or arising number of zero-day vulnerabilities. According to a study, a leading security education organization, the SANS Institute, has released a report describing the top cybersecurity risks. Now, because waves of targeted email attacks, often called spear phishing, are exploited vulnerabilities in commonly used programs such as Adobe PDF Reader, QuickTime, Adobe Flash, and Microsoft Office. Because the visitor feels safe downloading documents from trusted sites, they are easily fooled into opening documents and music and videos that exploit some vulnerabilities. Avoid selecting Keep Me Logged In or Remember Me. In other words, always log off from your Facebook page. Now, we have been asked about this particular instance in about a lot on our Facebook page. One such instance is every time a user has asked this, every time he or she goes on a Facebook login page, his email and password are already there in an autofill feature. It's always selected. Dots are placed in case of the actual password. So of course it has to protect the user, but anyone could just go onto the Facebook on their computer and log in as the user himself. The Keep Me Logged In box isn't even checked. The user had asked to eliminate the autofill feature from being enabled. So we answered this question by advising the user that you can turn off the autocomplete feature in your internet options. So whenever if you have saved your passwords or whenever you have enabled the autocomplete functionality in your web browser, you can do it by clicking the, for Windows, you can click on Start Control Panel Internet Options, and at the Content tab, there's an autocomplete section. You click on Settings and uncheck the boxes for forms and username passwords on forms, and then click OK. You can do the same thing for other browsers like Firefox and Chrome and disable the autofill function on your browsers. Moving ahead, always download free software from verified publishers. I've also explained to you this in the earlier opinion poll. So you need to be aware of the freeware that is available on the internet. Most importantly, online shopping is on the free, so you shop from trusted sites only. With the online industry, especially in India, it's booming. So it seems every day a new e-commerce portal is setting up a shop. With so many online retailers offering the same products, it becomes hard for customers to choose the right portal from their shopping needs. The concerns regarding an online shopping portal and making online transactions stem out from a few bad apples who scam people through different way, delivering defective or unoriginal products, stealing credit card and other financial details, not sending products at all after payments, etc. Just like there are a few bad apples in every industry, online retail also has its fair share, but you can always make sure that an e-commerce website is authentic and not before buying them. There are many ways you can make sure about the authenticity of any website before you purchase online. Few of the tips I would like to share with you. The first and the very foremost thing is reviews. We're not talking particularly about the reviews or the testimonials which are found solely on that particular website. But instead, we are talking about reviews that you can find in the other parts of the World Wide Web regarding that particular e-commerce website. Now, there are many review websites on which customers have previously bought products from an e-commerce website, and they share their experiences, good or bad. And they also register their complaints, because if this has to be, people has like to raise their voice on the internet, they definitely go and complain about a website, especially if it's a bad one. Second tip is an SSL certification. It's not a technical term. Let me simplify this for you. An authentic and serious e-commerce player will always have an SSL certification. The SSL encryption keeps all your financial information, like your credit card details, like your debit card details, etc., safe while you make an online purchase. The website which use SSL encryption generally have a high level of trust and a credibility amongst customers. As an online shopper, if an e-commerce website uses SSL encryption, you can identify it with the symbols like verify and secured. You can be sure that your financial details will remain safe and it cannot be misused. Let's move on. The next tip is addresses and contact information. Like an authentic e-commerce website would always provide its customers the information and details of how the customers can reach them in case they have any queries. Normally you find customer support numbers, email information, office address on e-commerce websites on its support page. A scam business will generally not share its contact information with the customers. You can check the authenticity of a website before buying. You can call the number mentioned, or you can send an email to a company representative to check the genuineness. Last but definitely not the least, policy. An authentic e-commerce portal will always mention its policies clearly to the customers. Before making a buying decision, it will be better if you spend some time going through the policies of the e-commerce websites regarding shipping, payments, returns, refund, exchanges, etc. Some websites also provide a guarantee on authenticity of the product sold by them or sold by the sellers listed on the website. The next step is know your friends online, accept friend requests only from people who you know. As we are all aware about cyber stalking or cyber bullying or about fraudulent transactions, you must always accept people or accept requests from people whom you know in person. Like a simple rule that as kids, our parents have taught us, always open doors to people whom you know. Don't open doors to strangers. I believe the same rule applies even to the cyber world. You should always accept friend requests only from people whom you know in person and not from a stranger, because you never know that stranger could be a good or a bad person. This brings me to another opinion poll. I would like to do a quick poll with you regarding passwords. Password containing only numbers are safe. Is it true? Is it false? I would like to know opinion from today's audience. If they feel passwords containing only numbers are safe. I have close to about 72% of today's audience casted their vote. I would still give them at least 10-15 more seconds before I close this opinion poll and share the results with you. Okay, I'll now close the opinion poll and share the results with you. Pat on your backs, audience, 97% of today's audience feels that passwords only with numbers is not safe. So exactly as I said in the previous slides, a strong password is the one that contains numbers, uppercase and lowercase letters and special characters. I would now proceed with the next part of the session. Whenever you shop or bank on the sites, it's always do check if the site URL, that is the address of the website, begins with an HTTPS. The HS in the HTTP after HTTP stands for secure. Whenever you have a URL starting with HTTPS, it's a secure site. Any information you place inside that site is encrypted and it's safe from being stolen. So regardless, you whichever site you go on, if you want to check if that site is, if you're sharing any information on that site, especially financial information like your credit card number or your internet banking passwords and usernames, make sure it begins from HTTPS. Very important tip, use a two-step verification. I'm sure you must have come across this phenomenon if you are a Google user, especially a Gmail user, or if you're a user of Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn or any of the majority social network sites. A two-step verification is basically a process where you use your username and password to log in. The moment you enter your password and you hit the login button, there is a passcode that is sent to your registered mobile number. Now that passcode is basically a 3 or 4 letter digit passcode which you can enter in the section where it asks for a passcode. So even in case somebody steals your username and password, but if you have your phone still with you, they will never be able to log into your account because the passcodes will every time come to your mobile phones. So another layer of security when you add to social network sites, especially, it makes you making cyber criminals difficult to enter into your social networking sites. Next, protect your PC from hackers and malware. In other words, use an antivirus. So, okay, regardless of your broader objectives of keeping your device healthy in every manner, the critical first step down the path is to have the security enhanced on your devices. So before you begin worrying about strong passwords, private communication, secure deletion, you need to make sure that your computer is not vulnerable to hackers or plagued or malicious software, often called as malware. Such viruses or spywares, otherwise it's impossible to guarantee the effectiveness of any other security precautions you might take. After all, there is no point in locking the door if the burglar is already inside your house, and it does not do much good to search downstairs if you leave your door wide open. So the first and the foremost thing is get an antivirus software which is adding a fort of security around your privacy and the information inside your computer, because that is going to lock down every possibility of somebody attacking your device and steal information from you. This is where I said it's important. Let me share you how can Quick Heal help you stay safe against all types of online dangers. So Quick Heal helps you keep your PC and its data safe from all types of internet dangers with its advanced security features such as web security. It automatically blocks websites that are designed to steal user information by social media scams, phishing attacks, or any social engineering techniques used by cyber criminals. Browser sandbox. It protects your PC from any malicious file that may get downloaded from the internet without your knowledge. So the moment if you have browser sandbox enabled, even if the file gets downloaded, it remains in a secure environment, and the moment you close the session or you close the browser, everything is wiped off clean. Every program which may have gotten downloaded without your knowledge gets wiped off. Email security. So the Quick Heal feature for email security blocks emails designed for phishing attacks or dropping a malware on the user's machine. Core protection. It stops all types of malware and viruses such as adware, that is advertising malware, spyware, which is a spying malware, Trojan horse, worms, etc. from infecting your machine or your PC. Advanced DNA scan. This is a patented technology from Quick Heal Technologies Limited. It detects and stops new and unknown threats that can cause heavy damage to your computer and the data inside your PC. Safe banking. We have introduced this newly feature in our version 16. It creates a safe virtual environment to let you bank, shop, and pay bills online securely. It protects your sensitive data from being stolen by spyware, keyloggers, and other malicious programs. Remember, cyber safety begins with you. So you have to be alert and aware of the happenings around your surrounding. Make sure you don't go on bad websites. Make sure you have a good antivirus to protect you against all these malicious threats around to keep you safe on the cyber world. This brings us to the end of this session. Thank you very much. If you have any queries regarding this webinar, you can write to us at corporatecommunications@quickheal.co.in. You can follow us on Facebook. The page is facebook.com/quickheal.av. On Twitter, our Twitter handle is twitter.com/quickheal. You can follow us on a Google Plus page. The bit.ly URL for it is bit.ly/quickheal.google+. You can watch the recording of this video on YouTube. The URL is youtube.com/quickheal. And this presentation would be hosted on SlideShare. The URL is slideshare.net/quickheal-ppts. For more information on Quick Heal products, please visit our website quickheal.com to know more about the cybersecurity updates and the recent happenings of security world. Visit us at blogs.quickheal.com. We'll now begin the question and answer session. I have a question from Balaraju Gunela. The mentioned phishing is blocking. How can you restrict for next time? Balaraju, I think this is not the exact forum where we can answer this kind of questions. It's more of a technical question. Please get in touch with our support team. They would be the best people to help you on your technical queries. I would really appreciate if you could restrict your queries and questions regarding the cybersecurity tips that we've discussed in today's webinar. Okay, Balaraju has another question. He's asked, in report Trojan are repaired is showing, does we believe Trojan will not affect again? So again, as I said, if we have a core protection system which basically protects you from Trojans, but again, this seems to be a technical question from you. In case you would like to know if what has happened with a particular quarantined file, you can get in touch with the support engineers in your area, or you can contact the support team from our website. You can raise a ticket for it. The URL is www.quickheal.co.in/submit-ticket. Kamlesh Karunakar has asked a question, can a zip file contain virus and will it be activated if I unzip it but do not open any file from it? So Kamlesh, a zip file, it can definitely contain a virus. I mean, you can't look at a name of a file and decide if it contains virus or not. It's better to have a protection in case you have a good security software. Then even if any zip file has a virus inside it, it will basically stop the operation and it will not let you execute the file or run the file. So basically it's like prevention is better than cure. We can always prevent any malicious files entering your PC by having a good security software to protect against all these threats. I hope this has answered your question. Vijay Kumar Vishwakarma has asked us a question, how do I know that a particular download is safe or not? Well, Vijay Kumar, whenever you are talking about any, I think you are talking about the free softwares available on the internet. So whenever you are downloading any software and you are not sure if this website or the software itself is genuine enough or not, as I said, do a review about that particular software on the World Wide Web. There are often people giving reviews about, you know, what is their experience of using that software, or was the intended use of the software exactly the same as described in the function of the software. So a review will always help you determine if you should go ahead and download that software. Also, make sure that you do a review about the website from where you are downloading the software. So if the genuine source or not of that particular software, very important thing to do. Rahul has asked us a question. Sometimes I get a message that explorer.exe stopped working. Does it caused by a virus or malware? How do I get rid of this problem? Rahul, to be honest with you, these are a very technical kind of questions. I would really expect you to stick to what has been discussed in today's webinar. If you have any problems using any software, I think you should get in touch with a technical support team for the same. Let's go to the next question. Suresh has asked us a question. What about the continued locked-in status in smartphones and iPads for social networking sites? Suresh, again, you have pointed out the right thing again. Even if you are using smartphones and you're logging into social networking sites from the smartphones and iPads using a web browser or the mobile browser, always it's always a good practice to log out. Because if you keep it logged in, and in case your device gets lost or stolen, and in case you haven't locked or put up enough security on your device, then anyone who finds your device can log into social networking sites and basically do any kind of damage that he has to do on it. Okay, we have another question from Vijay Kumar. Says recently my Facebook account had been hacked and someone was continuously posting and sharing on my timeline some bad videos. How was it happening? So Vijay, possibly somebody has managed to get into your username and password, and by doing it, he or she, whoever the cyber criminal is taking advantage of the less security measures that you have taken to protect your Facebook account. In order to regain your Facebook account, you can always do a forgot password. So you can get a link from Facebook which will send you a link to your registered email address, a link to reset the password. So that way you can reset the password. After you've reset the password, make sure you have a two-step verification done so that even if somebody manages to steal your password the next time, still the passcodes come to your mobile phone. That way you're adding an extra layer of security to your passcodes. Also, as I mentioned in my previous webinars, if you are using Facebook, make sure that you are protecting yourself. You're making changes to the privacy settings in Facebook so that whatever messages you post on Facebook are restricted to your friends. Do not go away to people who are unknown or looking at praise where they can use their techniques to catch hold of basically people who they can take advantage of. So in case you are using Facebook the next time, make sure you follow these guidelines so your account stays safe. Meher has asked us a question. What is the meaning of policies? So Meher, I believe you're talking about, when I was talking about doing an e-commerce transaction on websites, there are different policies that these e-commerce players have. Like for example, they have privacy policies where whatever information they you share with them. When you go to their e-commerce website, there are policies about what do they do about that information. Secondly, there are policies, different policies about shipping of the products or returns policies. Say, for example, if you buy a pair of clothes for yourself from an e-commerce portal, and in case they do not allow returns or if they are going to charge you for the returns of the pair of clothes that you have purchased, then you get to be aware of those policies after you have made the purchase. But instead, if you check those policies beforehand, then you would be safe to make a decision whether to go ahead and buy from such e-commerce website. So reading through policies is a very important part of e-commerce transactions. Mukesh Mehta has asked us a question, how to verify SSL certification before making credit card payment or final confirmation to check the payment process is secured. So Mukesh, whenever there is an SSL certificate on the page, there will be a logo of the provider of the SSL certification. So at times you may have a VeriSign authorized, or you may have a GeoTrust These are the two companies which provide SSL certificates to e-commerce websites. These are widely known SSL certification provider companies in the world. Going on to the next question. Suresh has asked us a question. Is a two-step verification necessary for every login? Suresh, I think I've already answered this question. Two-step verification helps you add an additional layer of security in case you have lost your username or password or somebody has managed to steal it from you. Still, he won't be able to log into your account because every time there is a two-step verification and somebody puts in the username and password, there is a passcode sent to your mobile phone device without which the person cannot proceed and enter the social media account. Okay, Mukesh has asked us a question. How to remove a yellow triangle displayed in a browser even I use HTTPS while I log in Yahoo email ID checked with and should contact you. Mukesh, I think you're referring to an expired SSL in this regard. So for all these websites where there is an SSL certificate which is expired, you generally get this warning that this website is not safe to be browsed. I think it's that's what you're referring to here. Satadil Guru has asked us a question. I have a question. It is it secure to use some adblock extension on Chrome in incognito mode or safe mode? So to answer your question, again, the same thing goes on here. Whenever you're using any third-party program and whenever you're using it as a browser extension even or a standalone software, always check who's the maker, creator of that software, who's the manufacturer of the software, and also do a review about that software. If you have whenever you do a review about a particular software, all the facts of the software, for example, if it's a good one, then you might find good reviews about it. It's a bad one, then it's a high probability that you'll definitely find reviews about a bad software. I have to use a green browser green border by Quickheal to ensure my browsing. Mukesh has asked this question. Well, Mukesh, I think you're referring to the browser sandbox. So whenever you are using a browser, make sure you're using that browser in a browser sandbox. It's a feature that is present in all Quickheal softwares, the desktop softwares, I'm talking about the Windows. So when you use a browser sandbox, there is a green layer that appears on the borders of your browser, which basically is a symbol that the browser sandbox has been activated on your browser. So it's safe for you to, even in accidentally, if there is any software download that happens without your knowledge, and the moment you close the browser, everything is wiped off clean. So even if there is a software downloaded, it does not harm basically your PC. Sumit Kumar has asked us a question. Softwares I use consume lots of memory and processor at times. So Sumit, I think if you have a question, a technical question, I would request you to get in touch with the technical team. They will be the best people to help you resolve your problem. Vicky Kumar has asked us a question. please send this presentation to me. Vicky, as I said, we will be sending out an emailer later tomorrow or next week, in which you'll have a recording of this webinar, a link to which would be on our YouTube channel, and also the link to a presentation which would be hosted on SlideShare. Arnab has said, thank you for your valuable webinar. Well, Arnab, you're most welcome. We thank you for attending today's webinar and hope you attend our upcoming webinars as well. Vinayak Kale has asked us a question. Can you please share the presentation after this webinar? Vinayak, as I said, this webinar would be hosted on SlideShare. So, how exactly save banking concept works. We have a question from Raj Singh, who's asked us, how does the safe banking concept work? So safe banking feature is a feature that's available in Quick Heal products. Using safe banking, whatever information you share on doing your banking transactions or e-commerce transactions, first it makes sure that you are not going to a bad website. You're going to a genuine website. It makes sure you go to a genuine website, and whatever information you share with those websites stays safe. So you can use the safe banking feature, which is available in the Quick Heal Total Security software, and make your transactions safer than ever. Praveen Srivastava has asked us a question. Which of your software provides a better security, Quick Heal Total Security or Internet Security? Well, Praveen, you can know more about the softwares if you visit our websites. Both these softwares have different features. Although all the features which are present in Internet Security are present in Total Security, with some more added features like parental control and PC tuner, which basically helps tune your computer and keep it up to the speed. Dharmesh has asked us a question. What if we wrongly or unknowingly surf bad websites? So Dharmesh, when you say that you accidentally land upon bad websites or websites meant for which have adult content, well, this is generally happening when you browse through different sites on the internet. So make sure that whichever site you are going to is safe enough. Don't click on unnecessary links. Especially these links would be provided, which will allure you in clicking on these links, which will probably have pictures or which will have free software download links or any of that sort. So don't click on those links where you do not want to land up onto bad websites. I hope this answers your question. Satish Patil has asked us a question that you've not mentioned anything about firewalls. So firewalls are an integral part of any security software that comes into you. So there are many aspects of a security software that we could have spoken about, but since we had less time on our hands, so I couldn't get into much details of it. Okay, let's move on to the next question. Rohit has asked us a question. Is antivirus important for our smartphones? Rohit, definitely the answer is yes. Antivirus software, security softwares are very important for your smartphones. As these days, everyone says that smartphones are replacing your PCs and your computers, which means that all the work that you've been doing on your PC or on a laptop will now be, you'll be doing it on your smartphone, which means that the security that you required on your laptop, you need a better security on your smartphones as well. So you can go through a list of different security softwares available in the market, or also on, if you're using an Android phone, you can go on Google Play to find about different security softwares that are available. If you'd like to know about the security softwares available on Android from QuickHeal, you can definitely visit our website, which is www.quickheal.com. Hope this answers your question. A website containing HTTPS can be hacked or not? Bimlay Singh is asking this question. Well, Bimlay Singh, if there are vulnerabilities in any website, then, and if there are errors or chances that there are some errors on the site, then it definitely can be hacked. If any of the website may it be an HTTPS or a regular website, HTTP, both can be hacked. The only difference between an HTTP and HTTPS is whatever information you put in into an HTTPS site gets encrypted. That's the basic difference. I think we have answered all the questions. Yeah. No. Secure sites asks for an option of visiting unsecured content. Should we select yes or no? Sudhakar has asked us this question. Sudhakar, it's a very important question. Now, whenever you are on a secure websites and there are pages which are not secure on the same website, it will ask you for a permission before going to such pages. So if you're not sure if you would like to go to unsecure pages on a website, then you definitely should not check out the option or as yes. You should always select no, because whenever you're switching on between secure and unsecure pages, there is information that can be captured from you. So don't put in or insert any information on unsecure pages, especially information about your financials or your personally identifiable information. We have CVK Shastri asking us a question. If we can have a session about various features that can be used by a user of QuickHeal version 16, or can we share information about the same? So to answer your question, all the features of the QuickHeal Total Security Software version 16 are explained on our website. If you have any particular question on using a particular feature of that software, you can definitely write to us and we'll be more than happy to explain the same to you. Let's move on to the next question. Deepak has asked us a very important question. Is it important to delete a low-risk malicious software? Deepak, I think you have answered your question yourself. If it's a malicious software, it should not be on your system. So any malicious software can increase the vulnerability of your system being attacked and used as a zombie system to attack other systems in your office or other systems that use in the same network. So if you have a malicious software, please get rid of it. Abhijit has asked us a question. Is it a good thing to keep logged in into official apps such as Facebook or Gmail? Abhijit, I think I've already answered this question. This will not only eat up the battery of your gadget, because it keeps on pinging the server for new updates, but also increases the security risks on your phone. Basant Gite has written a comment saying, thank you very much for this very informative webinar. Please repeat the steps of safe net banking. Vasanji, thank you very much for attending today's webinar. We would like to have you on our upcoming webinars as well. As I said earlier, I will be sharing this recording of today's webinar entirely with the question and answer session on our YouTube channel, so you can go through the same, not only your questions about safe net banking, but the entire webinar would be for your reference. Thank you very much. What will happen if I'm using an activated Windows 8.1 but activated the KMS? Vijay Kumar, Vishwakarma, we would not like to mention or talk about softwares which are not from a genuine source. If you're using pirated softwares, please refrain from using pirated softwares, as those softwares are incomplete in terms of security. Because these patched softwares are always vulnerable to attacks or to backdoor entry to your cyber criminals. So please stay away from patched softwares. Kavaljeet Singh has asked us a question. Do you think Google is safe for us because we are whenever we access or search something on the desktop, and after some time the search data is also showing on your mobile, tab, laptop, etc. So Kavaljeet Singh, to answer your question, whenever you are searching anything on Google and when you're logged in, there is a feature automatically enabled in your Google settings which keeps a log of your search history. You just log into your Google accounts and you can disable the option of keeping the search history alive. So that way Google will remember nothing about whatever you have used in the search feature. I hope this answers your question. How does Quick Heal Total Security product help post installation on mobile device against cyber attack? I think you're talking about the Total Security for Android product against cyber attack. So this basic feature has a lot of features inside the Quick Heal Total Security for Android software, where it can help you from cyber attacks, or because there's basic antivirus feature inside it also. How do I prevent or remove adware from my PC using Quick Heal? Santosh Pawar has asked us this question. Well, Santosh, if you want to remove so basically whenever you install Quick Heal software, the core protection technology of the software helps you prevent these spywares or adwares from getting into your PC. In case you have got them, then please contact our technical support experts and they'll help you and share tips with you on removing these adwares from your system. I have a question from Hemrat Singh Jadeja, where he's asked, any cracked software is harmful even if it's a standalone PC? Well, to be honest with you, all the unpatched software that we're talking about are vulnerable for attacks. So may it be a standalone PC or maybe a PC in your network, it's as harmful as it, because it basically opens opportunities for cyber criminals to sneak attack your PC in case they have to. So you don't use unpatched software. You know, as I explained even in my webinars, there are instances of security patches released by these genuine software makers to make the software more secure for the users to use. I hope this answers your question. I'm not sure what Purnima has asked us here. She has asked us how safe is it to do online work from home business. Purnima, I'm not sure I have understood your question. Can you please write to us at corporatecommunications@quickheal.co.in and our experts will answer your question in more detail. Gurbachan Singh has asked us a question. Is Quickheal software also available for Android phones? Yes, Gurbachan Singh. Quickheal softwares are available for Android phones. Please visit our website quickheal.com to know more about Quickheal products. We have various products for Android. A latest product that we have launched for Android is Fantastic, which is not only a software, but it's basically a friend software of your Android phone. I think we have almost covered all the questions. Mukesh Mehta has asked us the last question. Okay, thank you, Nikhil, for almost most of the most important learning which we must ensure for surf internet are covered by you. Thank you for the internet poll. Thank you. So Mukesh, well, thank you very much for attending today's session. We hope to have you on our upcoming sessions on cybersecurity. Kavaljit Singh, I think I've already answered your question about information stored on Google. Atul Bora has asked us a question. If the PC is not booting and needs formatting, how to check the license details if you're able to access the hard disk? I think this question is more relevant to your hardware vendor, Atul. He will be the best person to help you answer this question. For all the questions, I think we already have exhausted all the time we had at our hands. So in case you have further more questions, please do write to us at corporatecommunications@quickheal.co.in and our experts will be more than happy to assist you with their answers. I am now going to hand over the proceedings to Saurabh to conclude today's session. Thank you very much for attending today's webinar. Have a pleasant day.
Thank you everyone for being with us for this webinar. We hope the webinar has helped you understand the 10 cyber safety tips every internet user must know in a better manner. Have a great day ahead. Thank you.